Hey everybody, my name is Emily Henderson and I am an interior designer, stylist, blogger, TV host person. And typically I do videos, but they're more about how to style your mantle or how to like arrange pillows on a sofa. And this video is going to be way different. So here's the story. There are 50,000 homeless people in LA. There's probably way more than that, honestly. They don't even know how to count them. And many of them, thousands of them are children, like infants, two-year-olds, eight-year-olds, you know, like kids that are living on the street or in cars. I'm today at the San Fernando Rescue Mission, which is a family homeless shelter. You have to have children in order to be able to temporarily stay here. The shelter burned down last year, and it's been being rebuilt ever since then. And naturally, you can imagine that they don't have a huge budget to hire a design team or even to have nice furnishings. And that's where I come in, and that's where you come in. So I am volunteering my team to redesign the space, or to design the space for the first time, I guess. But we need support. We need money. It's 16,000 square feet. It's really, really big. And my goal and my job is to make it really inviting and homey and comfortable with the right amount of furniture and accessories and artwork and just a place that makes them feel not just safe, but also inspired. Shelters like this are actually helping the entire world because it's changing lives from when they're really young, like when they can actually fix these problems and become successful and independent adults. Especially as a parent now, knowing that your children have a safe place to sleep, that's huge. It's something that I for sure take for granted. Like, I can't imagine like worrying about whether Charlie has a safe place to sleep or not. And so I'm one of the lucky ones, and whatever you call how you were raised, whether it's lucky, charmed, blessed, if you weren't living in your car, you were one of those. And a lot of these families that stay here, they're not.
This mission right here, the rescue mission, is so lovely. It's a nice place to, I mean, just everything is appreciated, from the food to the beds, towels. People have really poured out their heart. The people that come and feed us, they have really been an example for all, well, for me. Because I'm looking at them and I'm looking at myself in the future of coming and helping someone. I was one that slept in the car with my kids. And I had to do what I had to do. I mean, no child should have to endure that. But through the mission, I mean, you know, this will help a lot of people. And it'll give the dignity and belief back in that love for the families. And that's what you bank on.
Our goal at the mission is to provide that dignity. I'm Wade Trimmer, I'm the director of the San Fernando Valley Rescue Mission. What originally inspired me to get involved in this issue of homelessness is that 20 years ago I was waiting for a movie in Westwood, and this little girl walked up to me and asked me for food. And it never occurred to me before that a child would be homeless. I knew of, you know, adult homelessness at that, but to think of a little girl who was homeless, it really just ruined my life in a really good way. And so I got out of line and I just asked her why she was homeless. I just wanted to hear her story. And she just explained to me this just awful story of this monster that her mom had married. And she ended up getting basically booted out of the car on Hollywood Boulevard with a backpack, and explained to me that she'd already been involved in, you know, just things that nobody should ever be involved with, much less a 12-year-old girl. And so I was really frustrated that night because I didn't know what else to do for Angel. And just kind of made a commitment to myself that I would never be in that situation again. 60% of our guests in our shelter throughout the years have been kids who are school-aged children. And the youngest kid in our shelter right now is a month old. So being able to intervene that early in a child's life is just critical to their long-term success and, you know, really thriving as people and contributing to society. So on May 3rd of last year, I woke up to find out that our building was on fire. We lost everything. Unfortunately for the families that we serve, the very little that they did have, they lost that. And so thankfully nobody was injured in the fire. We're so committed to opening a shelter as quickly as possible, and so we're in a new shelter now, and we're in the midst of building again this 90-bed shelter that will be done in April of this year. That's inspiring, that really helps with their healing, and that helps them move forward, and this should feel like a home. We want people not to live in a facility, but to live in a home, which is what we all want.
So, If you have $5, $10, $1,000, hey, if you have $10,000 extra laying around, please, please donate. Or if you have services that you want to donate instead, which is awesome, you can go to my blog, which is stylebyemilyhenderson.com. For those of you that are about to click donate, thank you so much from me, from the mission, and from, most importantly, the families that are going to start living here.